Next, we use an example to demonstrate how to apply the SGD algorithm. Consider the following optimization problem. This is the objective function. This is the expectation of fwx. I set f to this value, which is 1/2 times the norm squared of w minus x. If both are vectors, this is the square of their norm. Intuitively, this represents the distance between w and x. We aim to minimize the distance between them. Here, fwx equals this, and then I calculate the gradient of f. What is the gradient? It is w minus x. I will not derive this in detail here. If you are watching the video, you can pause and derive it yourself. Next, we have three exercises. If this were an offline course, I would pause to let the students practice. Of course, you can pause the video and do the exercises if you like, but here I will proceed directly and explain. The first exercise is whether we can prove that the optimal solution W star for this problem is the expectation of X. The second is to write out the gradient descent algorithm for solving this optimization problem. The third is to write out the stochastic gradient descent algorithm for solving this problem. We will provide the solutions to the last two exercises later. We next briefly derive this. We know that for J to reach its minimum, there is a necessary condition, which is that the gradient of JW should be equal to zero. Let's solve this and see what W we can get. The gradient outside can be taken inside, so we have this. This quantity should be zero. We know this equation and have provided it here, so it is W minus X. We can get EW minus X equals zero. W itself is not a random variable, so its expectation is itself. Therefore, we get W equals EX. Next, let's look at the second and third exercises. What is the gradient descent algorithm to solve this problem? It is WK plus 1 equals WK minus alpha K times this gradient. Here, the gradient contains the expectation. Then I calculate the gradient of F here, which is WK minus X. This is the gradient descent algorithm. Then, what is the corresponding SGD algorithm? It is actually very simple. We can remove the expectation here and directly replace it with WK minus XK. This is the corresponding SGD algorithm. As you can see from the above process, we first understand gradient descent, knowing that it contains an expectation. Then we remove this expectation to obtain SGD. This algorithm might look familiar to you. The algorithm WK plus 1 equals WK minus alpha K times WK minus XK is actually the algorithm that we introduced at the beginning of this lecture for solving the mean estimation problem. That is, I have an X and want to find its expectation, EX. How do I do this? I have a set of samples XI, and by putting these XI one by one into this algorithm, I can eventually approximate the expectation. This is what we introduced at the beginning of this lecture. At the beginning of this lecture, we also mentioned that if alpha k was equal to 1 over k, then wk was indeed the exact average of the first kxi. But we didn't introduce what happens when alpha k is not 1 over k. Now we understand that this algorithm can still work even if alpha k is not 1 over k because it is actually a special SGD algorithm. The problem description is different. Before, it was about finding x. Now it is described as an optimization problem, but they are fundamentally the same. To summarize, we introduced the SGD algorithm and demonstrated with examples how to apply this algorithm. Additionally, we pointed out that the iterative algorithm for mean estimation that we mentioned earlier is actually a special SGD algorithm. Next, let's discuss the convergence of the SGD algorithm. Why is SGD effective? The basic idea of SGD comes from GD, that is, gradient descent. Here, the expectation E is unknown, so we simply remove it and approximate with this sample, which gives us SGD. This gradient here has a name. It is called stochastic gradient, whereas this one is called true gradient. If we use the stochastic gradient to replace the true gradient, then there is certainly an error between them. So, they satisfy this equation. The stochastic gradient equals the true gradient plus this error. In this case, can we guarantee that SGD can successfully find the optimal solution W star? The answer is yes. Now let's see the proof. The basic idea of the proof is to show that SGD is a special RM algorithm. Since we already know that the RM algorithm converges under certain conditions, we can know under what conditions SGD also converges. This idea is very straightforward. Another approach is to prove the convergence of SGD directly, without relying on RM algorithms. This proof is very complex. Interested readers can find it in my book. Here I just show that SGD is a special RM algorithm. What problem is SGD trying to solve? It aims to minimize this objective function. This optimization problem can be converted to a root-finding problem. Specifically, the necessary condition for this objective function to be optimal is that its gradient should be zero. If we let GW be this gradient, solving this optimization problem becomes solving this equation GW equals zero. How to solve the equation GW equals zero? We already know that we can use the RM algorithm to solve it. Here, the value of GW is unknown. However, we have some measurements represented by G tilde. The measurement G tilde is the stochastic gradient, which equals GW plus some noise. Then the corresponding RM algorithm is WK plus 1 equals WK minus AK times this noisy measurement, G tilde. When we substitute G tilde with the stochastic gradient, the RM algorithm becomes the SGD algorithm. In other words, the SGD algorithm is a special RM algorithm solving a specific problem. Since SGD is a special RM algorithm, we can apply the convergence conclusions of RM algorithms to analyze the convergence of SGD, leading us to this conclusion. Let's briefly go through this conclusion. If SGD satisfies the following three conditions, then WK will eventually converge to W star, which is the solution to the equation with probability 1. The first condition is about the properties of F. Essentially, it means that F should be strictly convex, which is a convexity condition. Note that F is a scalar here, and we assume that W is also a scalar. Therefore, the upper and lower bounds are also scalars. If W is a vector, then the bounds should be matrices. The second condition is about the coefficient AK. Basically, it involves two equations. The sum of AK should be infinite, and the sum of the squares of AK should be finite. The third condition is about the sampling. It requires that the samples be IID. Under these conditions, we can guarantee that SGD can successfully converge to W star. For the detailed proof, you can refer to my book.